What's going on, gamers? Today, we're going to be going over how to add a whitelist to your Rust server. Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. Rust is definitely one of the more social games available, with all of the servers being open to the community at all times. This can get a little crazy when you can't control who enters your server, and whether someone joins through a specific IP address or finds the server in the community list, there are times when you might decide that you'd rather keep your server private, only allowing a select amount of people to enter. Whether it's because you want to see how far you and your friends can get on your own, or if you don't want to risk somebody coming in and messing up your hard work, this is all possible with the whitelist mod by Wulf, which gives you the power to allow only specific players to join. Today, let's go over how to get started. First, you will need to download the Whitelist Rust mod on the UMod website. After that, head into your Apex server panel and stop the server. Scroll down to the Enable UMod Support, make sure it's checked, and then press Save. Once you've saved, head to the FTP file access on the left and then log in. On the next page, you'll want to find the Oxide folder and then the Plugins folder. Press Upload in the top left and then drag and drop the downloaded whitelist mod. Once it has completely uploaded, you can return to the main panel page and restart the server. Now that you have the mod enabled and installed, you'll need to add players to your whitelist. To do this, head into the steam.io website and then search for the player that you want to whitelist. Copy their Steam ID 64 number and then head back to your Apex server panel. Find the console tab on the left and on the next page in the text field, enter this command while making sure to replace the Steam ID here section with the Steam ID 64 number from earlier. With that, your Rust server should now have the whitelist enabled, so only the approved players are able to join. Remember that by default, any player that's given admin privileges through the Oxide commands will be able to join even if they're not put onto the whitelist. But if any other player tries to join, they'll be kicked and told they need to be whitelisted. Whether you're using this to work on your server yourself, keeping it private for select people, or anything else, the whitelist is a great way to make sure that you can control who's allowed to enter your server. That's it for this one, gamers. As always, I hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.